Hello guys, welcome back to the decoration video, and we'll be, well, decorating the house today. So, I went ahead and I filled in all the windows, and I put in most of the doors. I forgot a few, but otherwise the house is exactly the same. Actually, right here, I did add, fix the window because I never put that in. So, you go into the left side of the house. You add us one more block on the sides of it, and then you split it down the middle. Nothing crazy. Sorry, I forgot to put that in the video. And the rest, and like over there, the rest of the house is exactly the same. That's the only part I did change. But otherwise, we're good. So today we'll be decorating this bad boy. All we're going to need really is some other stuff, some like bookshelves and stuff. But for anyone who's watching this, you're wondering, where the heck is the top of this part of the house? Where's that bedroom? Well, I don't like it there, so I took it out. I like the original design. But for today, like I said, we're just going to need like bookshelves, fence, glowstone, trapdoor, and a torch. Torches are essential. So right here, go ahead and place two bookshelves underneath the front window. And then over here, we're going to place bookshelves going towards the dining room. Not in the dining room, towards it. And then go ahead and get your fence. And we're going to stack it too high on the ends of it. So go ahead and get a trapdoor out and place it on top. Just like that. And then if you want, you can go ahead and place a painting right here. If I can get one that works. There we go. And also there's another design that works well for this house. On the left side, actually, we're going to take this out. We're going to build a grandfather clock. You can still leave it the way it is if you don't want to build one, or you can have a cool little grandfather clock right over here. So for the clock, all we're going to need is a spruce log, or any log of your choice. I prefer spruce. Two doors, specifically, a button, a redstone torch, and a redstone lamp. Also, you're going to need, like, a, what'd you call it, a, can't think of the name, a item frame. You're just gonna need an item frame and a clock. I remember the clock, but I was trying to remember the item frame, that was bugging me. Have an off day. So, just kind of place it just like how kind of I am. It's real easy. It's nothing like rocket science. Don't want snow. Here we go. Alright, and just go ahead and get rid of those two, because we will not need that anymore for the rest of the house, unless you want to build another grandfather clock somewhere. And go ahead and get your item frame and your clock. Just like that, and there's your little grandfather clock. Cool, ain't it? And also it lights up the room really good, so, you know. Helps keep out monsters. So now we're going to go, let's see, what do I want to go with? Oh, in here. Right here we can actually place like jack-o'-lanterns or glowstone behind the painting, because light shows through paintings. So if you want to light up the room kind of evenly, go ahead and place jack-o'-lanterns or glowstone. I prefer jack-o'-lanterns because they're cheaper to make. Just like this. So it kind of lights up both sides of the room, so you don't need as many torches. Go ahead and get some black wool and brown wool out, or any color of your choice. It's just what I'm going to use today. So, let's see. Yeah, we can't go too far to the side or else it's gonna get cut off. So line up, just do like a 3 by 5 rug going down the center, skipping one block from the bookshelf by the window, or by the front of the house. Yeah, just line it up with that and do a 5 by 3. Gives it a different kind of look for the house. Yeah, I just think, you know, it spices up the place. So, let's see. Where do we go next? Alright, we're going to do the living room, or whatever you want to call it. So for this, let's see, what are we going to use? We're going to use at least a torch, spruce stairs, stone slab for a table, a painting, and let's get some gray wool. That's going to be the carpet in here. So go ahead and lay your stairs like this. It's going to be like a wraparound couch. Just like that. Then go ahead and place your stone slab right in the middle so that you can walk around it. And then go ahead and place your gray carpet. We're going to place this around the whole thing. And then we're going to pop it out. We're going to, of course, delete some of it as we go. And since I don't like how that looks, we're actually going to flip the door, which means you're going to need a whole block of quartz. So if it doesn't bother you and you're cheap on quartz, go ahead, leave it that way. But for my decoration purposes, I don't like it, so I'm going to change it. And also, let's go ahead and place a jukebox here, if I can hold it. Go ahead and place it right there. And if you want, you can even place like a chest right next to it. If you want to, like, to hold all your stuff, you know, hold all your discs. Let's see. Yeah, you can't place it like this. It works pretty good. I've done that in my houses a couple times. And let's see, feels like this room's missing something. It's missing bookshelves and a flower pot. Definitely a flower pot. Love those. Just with cactus on top, you know. I'm not loving it there. I don't like it blocking the window. So, here we go. That looks a little better. Doesn't block the view. So, right here, if you want, you can place a painting there if you want. And see what else. Yeah, you could place a painting in if you wanted to. You could put like jack-o'-lanterns or glowstone behind it. Light up the place. Just like this right here. And of course, we gotta fix that now. Just like that. It looks a little better now. Because you don't need it now. But let's see, what else can we do? Let's start in the dining room. So go ahead and get rid of everything. Put the torches and the spruce stairs. I don't think we'll really need anything else. Oh, yeah, that's right, we're going to need a piston and a redstone torch to make the piston come up. You can use anything, like you can use fence or whatever else you can think of. It doesn't really matter what it is, it just, you know, symbolizes a table. And of course, place, make this just centered, so skip one from the back wall. Place your chairs. We're going to call them chairs instead of stairs. Place your table right down the middle, and then place your other set of chairs on the other side. And then go ahead and place some item frames as corners. And you'll see why I picked item frames rather than signs in a moment. So now that we're done with that, we're gonna lay down the carpet. I'm thinking brown carpet for the dining room. I've always used brown for some reason, I'm not quite sure. And see, if we had a sign, we wouldn't be able to put carpet there. Just like that, see? Now, of course, we're going to need to light this up because we don't want any creepy spunning in here. Right, just like that. And actually, go ahead and move these in one more just so they get more of the area. If you want, you can place an extra torch there because it seems a little dark. You can do it on the other side too if you felt like it. So, let's see what else. We'll go ahead and place a bookshelf here, maybe. Maybe. I'm not really sure how this is going to look. Whenever I I just kind of like free ball like what's kind of going on. I don't really ever plan out like how I'm going to really decorate the house. So actually, I'm not liking how this is looking. I think we're just going to put it in the corners maybe, or just leave it like that. I don't know. Yeah, I think we're just going to put it in the corners. And then go ahead and get your pot and your cactus out. And we're going to go ahead and put that on all of them. I like using cactus. I think it looks the best of all of them. I think a flower looks weird. A sapling looks weird. A mushroom would just be actually kind of be funny. I would put a mushroom just to laugh. And you probably don't. You only need like one torch on that side because the whole thing is lit up already. And then go ahead and just place torches right here. Then go ahead and line up. Actually, no, right here. Actually, we're going to go ahead and get our fence. This is going to be our balcony banister so you don't fall off. So, and also we're going to do a, a chandelier. So, make sure we count out how wide the whole thing is. And if I'm right, you want to move 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is the dead point of this. So you want to go up to 4 blocks, and then you want to find the dead center, which is the middle window. So go ahead and start making the chandelier. Nothing. We're not going to use glowstone or anything. We're just going to use torches for this one. Glowstone, I think, is too bulky. Just go ahead and place it on top. And I'm actually not liking how low that hangs. I'm not liking that. We're going to go ahead and actually raise this up one more. So go ahead and just delete that bottom one. It's actually never existed. We're just going to line it up with how high the banister is. And much better. I think it looks a lot better. So now we're going to start working on the kitchen / storage room. So we're going to go ahead and throw away the rest of that. I don't think we need that right now. Go ahead and place your torches around, light the place up. And for here, it's going to be a bit of a problem placing torches. So actually right here, I'm going to break this and I'm going to replace it back as sandstone, because I think a wall there would actually be better than glass. Wait, what? What the heck am I doing? That's the exact opposite of what I wanted to do. Alright, so that's how we're going to light up that room, because that's really the only way how to light it up. Because the whole thing is going to be loaded with chests. So go ahead and put your ender chest smack dab in the middle, and we're just going to place our normal chest along the walls. And let's see. Oh yeah, go ahead and get your oak wood slab or whatever wood you use as the ceiling. And we're going to use the slab version so we can place an extra row of chests on top, so you can get the maximum of your storage space. So you can place it all the way up, see? You can still open it. So yeah, go just keep placing them all up. And it's a lot of chests, but you know, if you're a hoarder and you keep everything in this game, it's totally worth it. And it keeps all of your stuff in one room, so you don't have to run all over looking for it. I recommend like organizing your chests. Like having a friend take away your powers or something, and you place a sign or something. Or like put an item frame on it. Just kind of like tell you what it is. But for this part now, we're just going to need a crafting table, an anvil, a furnace, a cauldron, and a brewing stand. I think that's all we're going to use for this. So go ahead and just load the furnaces up on these sides. Don't do the top. We're going to put a torch there maybe. And go ahead and just take some bricks and go along the whole side wall. That's going to be our main block. And go ahead and actually do that on both sides. The bricks are going to be like our main work area, whatever you want to call it. I'm gonna go ahead and get it. Alright, so let's see. We're going to place this right down the middle. So go ahead and skip 3. Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna skip 3 from the furnaces, right down the middle, and just continue it. And I also want to let you guys know, I'm sorry if my voice seems to cut. It only lets me run 5 minutes, and then I have to edit it all together, so my voice cuts. I'm sorry. I don't always remember what I was just saying. So go ahead and place your cauldrons there. We can go ahead and leave the brewing stand on the right side there. Kind of like them there. And then go ahead and build this up. We're going to make a window right here. Actually, instead, we're going to make a window by the sink. And I think what we're going to do is we're going to make a refrigerator. If no one here knows how to make a refrigerator, what you're going to need is you're going to need a dispenser, a iron door, and you're going to need an iron block in a moment. Let's see. Also, we're going to need a button. Wooden button, stone button, it doesn't really matter. It's your preference. But, go ahead and build that up so you should have 2 double windows. Place the door, and don't forget you need to have that as a full block, so make sure when you place that it is a full stone slab, because you can't place a door on slabs, top slabs, for some reason. I have no idea why. I think it's a dumb idea, but hey, am I the judge of that? So go ahead and place your buttons on the brick, and it makes it look a little more realistic, like drawers or cupboards. And so go ahead and place your iron block in the back of that. And there's your refrigerator. Of course, you can place food in there and all that. And so it shoots food out, which is, I think, is amazing. If you ask me, anything that shoots food out of a fridge, like a food gun, ooh. Go ahead. The anvil doesn't really matter where you can place it. You can place it in the corner by the chest room. It doesn't really matter. They're really expensive, so I wouldn't place a whole bunch. Of course, unless you don't care. Then you can do whatever you want, because it's your house. Let's see. I think it needs some more torches. Light up the place. And I think we're going to need some glowstone. So go ahead and get some glowstone and a trapdoor. Because the trapdoor is going to make it look a little more fancy. So you don't have to look at all the glowstone weirdness. Just like that. Of course, the bottom half, you're going to see it. Unless you want to place a top slab, then that's cool. I used to do that, but I don't like how much space it takes up at the bottom. And don't forget to place all your windows in that room. I don't think I will. Nope, I'm not placing windows today. So, well, I guess I am. Like I said, I have to do a voiceover, so I'm trying to remember what I did. Same time and improvise. It's real fun sometimes. Go ahead and fill your cauldrons up if you're one of those people that like having full cauldrons. Let's see. You can place a painting in there if you feel like it. You go ahead and place your jack-o'-lanterns or glowstone behind that. Go ahead and place a painting. I always put a block on the side just to keep it from doing double-sized paintings. It helps a lot. And yeah, see, I get tired of it and I just did that. You can place 2 of those there, but I'm not going to because they're expensive. This is creative mode though, but I don't care. But alright, let's see what else. We're going to do the bathroom now. The bathroom is real simple. All you're going to need is some torches, I think we're going to use a picture frame for this. We're going to need the windows. Glass, of course, to fill in the window. You're going to need some sandstone slabs, the cauldron, and let's see what else. Some buttons, I think we're going to place right there. Yep. We're going to need a trapdoor, a bucket of water. We're going to use a picture for this. So, whatever you want your little person to look like, and I'm going to pick the funkiest looking picture. Ooh, imagine waking up to that in the morning. But right here we're going to make a Minecraft toilet. And what is it that you say? Minecraft toilet? That's crazy. But in this, it's gonna look like a weird little thing in the corner. It's just for decoration purposes. I guess that you could use it as like a real, like if you wanted to get like rid of stuff. Like the one on my survival world, it actually worked. Like when you hit the button, a piece pulled back, water came out and flushed it all away. It was actually really cool. It worked kind of like a garbage can almost. But you can put the button anywhere you want. You can put it there if you want the hatch to come up. You could put it on the actual piece and just make it look better. But it doesn't really matter. So let's see, this looks like the bottom part of the house is done. So now we're going to start working on the rest of the house. So for in here, I don't like just looking at the wood. So we're going to go ahead and get our gray wool out. We're just going to cover this whole area with gray wool. And keep your gray wool out because that will be the carpet of the upstairs. I do have a thing for you guys. When we're going to place the carpet upstairs, don't be afraid to put like gray wool underneath the door instead of a wood block. It doesn't show because we're going to cover this whole thing, and when we flip the door around, I'm going to probably flip the door around or something just because I don't want to see the carpet. I don't know, it's weird. You guys will know what I mean when we get there. I don't actually change it in the video. I actually did that on my side and I found that out. I was like, oh, this is an amazing idea. So, yeah. Just have to tell you guys. But right here, go ahead and put like some little love seats or whatever you want to call them. Then get your, what's it called? What's it called? Stone slab. Let's see, where is it? Where is it? Or no, first we want to put a jukebox there. Jukebox first. That one, you could put a note block there. It doesn't really even matter for that. I just wanted to put it there for decoration. And since I don't think that really looks very good, actually, we're going to go ahead and connect all that. There we go. Now we're high rolling. I thought about putting a TV up here, just for the heck of it, but it's not big enough. If it didn't have a room on the left side, or that entryway right there, I would totally do a TV. Don't forget to put torches in here. You don't want creepy spawning in here because then they'll blow up all your hard work. And we don't want that. So, then go ahead and put some in the storage, in the stairwell. Oh, I can't talk today. And that does not look good, so I'm gonna leave it like that. Alrighty, that looks good. So now time to do the bedroom. I am crappy at decorating bedrooms. Just to let you guys know, until I made this video, I thought I could never make a decent looking bedroom. The times have turned and I've made something decent. So if we're gonna make a TV first, because you know every bedroom is gonna need like a 60-inch Mitsubishi. Everyone loves those. So go ahead and get some stone brick stairs and some black wool or clay or whatever you wanna use. And go ahead and get some trap doors. We're gonna need that too. So we're going to actually split this right down the middle. So for this, we're gonna do two blocks. We're gonna make it an even size TV. And see, that has a weird looking base, so we're going to change that up. I don't like the way that looks. You can do all different sorts of types of bases. Like you do a base like that. You could do when we put slabs inside it, which I think that's what I'm gonna do. Yeah, see that, or you could do a base like that, which is like what I'm going to have. I think that looks a little better. Or you could even do double stairs on the inside. That might look good. And then just put your trap doors around the sides of it. Give it kind of like a frame, almost. If you don't want the frame, you don't have to. My Mitsubishi for this episode will have a frame for it, which you don't see normally. So the bed, we're not going to line it up with the window because it wouldn't line up with the TV. You know, the TV is more important than the window. So go ahead and I want to do like a border around the bed. So this might take me a couple times to figure out what looks good. I was like starting with the wood or the, you know, the actual floor color just to see what it would look like. And I have a feeling that that this is not going to look good. And I tried double raising it just to see it like that, and that looks horrible. Ooh, yeah, it looks horrible. So this is not going to work. And even like that, yeah, I'm not loving that either. So we're going to have to use something else. Let's do stone brick slabs. That's okay. I can live with that. Let's put something in the back. Let's see what it turns out to look like. See, it's used spruce wood. That's my favorite type of log to use. I like the darker stuff. And let's see. Let's go ahead and slap the stone brick slabs down. And that does not look bad. That looks pretty mean. Alright, and now we're going to go ahead and lay some gray carpet down. And you should always, I think you should have a chest in the room that you live in. Just so like you can put like your really important stuff in there. So like if some griefer comes, odds are, you know, they're not going to look in your bedroom for something. They're going to look in wherever you keep all your chests. So, you know, it kind of works out sometimes. It's just something, also, I think it just does something with the room, you know. Helps make the room look better. And actually, if you wanted to, you could probably put a shelf on that back wall. But I'm not going to do a shelf in this room. I'll do a shelf in the next room, though. So if you want to see that, stay tuned. Maybe we could totally put shelves on that wall. But, since I'm voiceovering this, it doesn't matter what I say, because it doesn't matter. So, I think that's going to be it for this room, at least for, actually us decorating. You can, of course, do whatever you want. But you could put bookshelves underneath the window. You could put bookshelves underneath the left window. You can do anything you want. It's all up to you. It's completely your house. You could have even made the house look completely different. This room could even have a deck if you wanted to. Oh, wait. Oh, shoot. Oh my god, I forgot. I did do a shelf. Oh, shoot. I forgot completely about that. That's right, I did do one. Never mind. I am sorry. I thought I didn't do a shelf in this video. There we go. Yeah, that looks good. I am sorry. I thought I didn't do a shelf in this video. I don't really normally build shelves in my houses. So when I do it, it's very common. Or very uncommon. Oh shoot, I didn't realize I did that. I just got done telling you guys I wasn't going to do one. Yeah, shelves over there. That looks great. You could even put some bookshelves over there underneath the window, but I know for a fact I didn't do that. So, you know, do what you want. And then outside on the deck, we're going to go ahead and dress this up too. So go ahead and get your spruce stairs out, and we're going to just put like a little bench underneath the window. And then we're going to get stone slabs. We're going to put a stone slab. Actually, you know, let's make that stone slabs. Yeah, I think that looks better. It's also a great escape plan for, you know, if you ever have to jump off the roof for some weird reason. Works out great for it. And on this side, we're not going to do anything special other than add a door. So go ahead and get your torches out. We're going to light up this side right here, so right in the middle. Just like that. Good. It's coming together good. That's almost done. I should only have one more video after this. Yeah, I do. So, yep. So, you go ahead and just keep putting torches like in the dead center. And it'll be good. We're not going to put like a bench or anything out here, but if you want, you could. If you felt like it. And then, of course, go ahead and light up the room. We don't want creepy spawning in here. Alright, this room, I didn't do anything like crazy special with, only because it's kind of small and it's the guest bedroom, so limit yourself, don't go all out if you want to. I don't really spend a whole bunch of time on this room, guys, because, you know, odds are you're not going to have somebody sleeping in here unless you're one of those people that, like, on server, that are, like, on the computer servers or something, that, like, to rent out your house or something. You know, it's a guest bedroom, just for, either for decoration or so that you can't have, like, a buddy bunk with you or something, like, you know. But for this piece right here, I'm going to make, like, a dresser or a drawer thing. And I don't want to use buttons because we're going to go ahead and lay down some carpet in a minute, and the button will take up that whole block, which I think is stupid, but oh well. So we're going to just use it like that today. I'm not going to decorate this room a whole lot just because it's really small, like I already said. I think we're just going to do like a big shelf in the back. So go ahead, we're going to take the middle three back wall, and we're going to need your oak slab, stairs of oak wood. So go ahead and make an upside down round top of the normal stairs so you have the bigger chunk at the bottom, and then put an upside down slab, and we're going to place it like this now. So it should look like an A almost. Yeah, looks like an A. You have the big piece on the bottom, and you have the tiny piece on top. So go ahead and get a bookshelf, if I can find one. There we go. And go ahead and place that right there, underneath the window. That's all we're going to do for this room. I just want to put a painting behind the bed or something. Otherwise, this house is completely done on the inside, unless you want to do something, like personally do it on your house. But, you know, at your house, do whatever you want to it. So, hope you guys enjoyed the house. Let me know how I did. Let me know if you want me to keep building sandstone houses or the wood houses, like the one on the right. So, you guys see a better picture of a second. I'm going to do some outer decorations. I'm just going to place some jungle leaves and a pumpkin or jack-o'-lanterns. Gives it a little bit, not only does it keep away monsters at night, but it also looks good. I like using jungle leaves, I think they're better, because they don't look as intricate and crazy as the normal leaves. They should look like that. So let me know if you guys want to build more wood houses or more sandstone. I prefer building sandstone, but you know, about what you guys want me to build. So, yep. See what I'm going to rubber stuff before I have decided to afford my fingers out. I think that's about it. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, let me know how I did. I think I already said that. I'm trying to find something else. I know I'm missing something. Oh well. But, yeah, just let me know if you guys want me to build either house. I think most people are going to pick the wood, just because you see more wood. The sandstone's not as common, and I don't think a lot of people like building with sandstone. But, preference, doesn't matter to me. I like building both. So, yeah, get the name out there. I am trying to get a whole bunch of subscribers, viewers, and all that, because it tells me that somebody at least likes my stuff. So, I hope I can get the name out there. Maybe some cool money producer guy sees this and wants to offer me big bucks for me for Minecraft houses. Which, that's amazing! That would be amazing. So, yep. Little stupid thing, we're gonna build houses along this road, so you guys will see past houses across the road. So if you guys ever, like, see it, you guys will be able to see all my houses at once, kind of. You'll be able to go back and look at the other videos and how to make them. So, I'll see you guys later, and that's Stardew out.